In this video, we are going to learn about imaginary and complex numbers. Before, we say that square root of negative 1 has no real solution. In sets of real numbers, negative do not have square roots. And imaginary numbers were invented so that negative numbers would have square roots and certain equation would have solution. These numbers were devised using an imaginary unit named I. So we say that I now is equals to square root of negative we have 1. So therefore, in every we have negative numbers, we can solve now using square root of negative 1 equal to I. The imaginary number consists of all numbers bi, where b is the real number and I is the imaginary unit, with the property that I squared is equal to 1. There is a pattern for the power or the exponent of imaginary numbers. So these are the four patterns that we need to remember in solving the exponent of imaginary number. First is I. Raised to the power of 1 is equals to I. I squared, which is equals to negative 1. I cubed is equal to negative I. And I to the power of 4 is equal to 1. So therefore, we can conclude that powers of I is in the pattern of 4. So therefore, whatever the exponent of imaginary numbers, we have to divide it by 4 if it is more than 4. So no remainder when you're going to divide now, when you're going to divide, if the answer, and then there will be no remainder, the answer will become 1. Here the other 1, if the remainder is equal to 1, so therefore that is equal to I. If the remainder is equal to 2, that is equal to negative 1. Or it says here, I squared. If it is I cubed, it will give us I cubed here. I cubed is equals to negative I, which is the remainder of 3. Okay? So, we will try now to solve these examples. Find I raised to the power of 23. So, 23 divided by 4. So we can have now as 23 divided by 4. So therefore we will have now as 5/23. So therefore this one is also equal to I raised to the power of 3, which is equal to negative I. The next one we have 2006. So 2006, when you're going to divide that, divide by 4, so therefore we have 5, 20, 0, we have 1, 4, 2. So therefore, I raised to the power of 206 is also equals to I squared, which is equal now to negative 1. I raised to the power of 37, so 37 divide by, we have, or 37 divide by 4, so we have now 9. 36, remainder 1. So we will have now as I raised to the power of 1, which is equal to I. The last one, we have 828 divided by 4. So therefore, we don't have, that is 2, that is 7 there, right? 0, 207, yes? So we can have now as 0 remainder, so therefore that is I raised to 0 is equals to 1. So when you can observe here that we have the pattern of 4, we always divided by 4. So when you going to solve problems greater than we have, or the exponent of imaginary numbers is greater than 4, what you're going to do? You have to divide only by 4. Now, let's try some example simplifying problems with negative in a square root inside. So for example, square root of negative 7. Square root of negative 7 is also equals to square root of negative 1 times square root of 7. Remember that I is equals to square root of negative 1. So therefore, we can have now as I square root of 7. Another example. For example, we have square root of negative 160. Let's try to factor it out first. So we can have also square root of negative 1 times square root of 160. So therefore, we will have now as I square root of 160. But still, we can simplify this one, 160. How much we gonna do for that? So we have 4 or 16, right? 160 can be factored out as 16 times 10. So square root of I square root of 16 times square root of 10. So therefore, we will have now as 4i square root of 10. So this one now will be your final answer. So every time when you're going to solve for any equation, you have to simplify it in the simplest form. That's all. Thank you so much and have a nice day.